of times when you have professors, especially at large research universities, you know, there seems to be almost like this air, you know, that they're a professor, you're a teacher. We didn't get that at all with these. In fact, these were some of the greatest individuals. Not only did they have a huge base of content knowledge and their understanding was amazing, they were really willing to work. They were willing to bring their knowledge on a level that could be applicable to middle school students, to high school students. They were willing to let you ask questions. They were willing to let you pick their brain. I was very nervous about working with university professors. Just, you know, everybody knows, you know, some can be, just like any other teacher, some can be difficult to work with and some can be very easy to work with. And we just got amazing professors. So we were very fortunate.
We began to evolve into a true partnership and not just a university hosting a two-week summer institute for teachers and then them going back and doing things. We tried to embed it year-long. And so we have found that that works very well with us, and we are so thankful to have the university partners we do, because they really work with us on that and making the learning meaningful for our teachers, not just to increase teacher content knowledge, but also to do things that are really going to make a difference for students in our classroom. They've just worked with us in a great way to make sure that we're meeting those needs for our students and our teachers.
We work closely with the UGA partners to learn strategies and different technological things that we can use inside the classroom. They also bring in people from the community, and we have a business panel discussion where we learn what businesses are looking for out of math and science students, or in their job, what kind of math and science skills they will need coming out of high school, if they need to go to college. You know, what should we be pushing our students to do? And then we work with the partners at UGA to also create lessons that will be beneficial to the students.
Well, I think it's what the partnership helps us see is beyond our own four walls of school. We could get very much just drawn into just doing things as is. And with our university partners, they offer us opportunities to see things from a different perspective. They help broaden our world, I guess you could say. And they bring to us like the latest learning in where we need to be going with education in the 21st century. How can math and science move things in our nation? And why is it important for us to teach those things to our students? Help them find out what opportunities are there. Our teachers find those things out, then they communicate them to their students. But not only do they do that, but they help us in finding methods to make that happen, like you've heard from our teachers about how to make that learning more engaging through project-based learning. And our partners have helped us tremendously in understanding how to do project-based learning, not just a project that's an activity out there, but that really embeds the actual standards that our teachers are supposed to be teaching, but in a way that students get involved in it.
So we get to see what is out there for the students, you know, because there's a lot of jobs that I would never mention to students that are in a math and science field that they would probably enjoy. So that's really interesting. And the way it impacts the school, a lot of it is project-based. And so it's very hands-on. The kids really enjoy that. It seems to stick in their minds a lot more, the content and what we are learning outcomes for them. Just they really learn them.
There's a push for college and career readiness, and that's exactly the work that MSP is really trying to do. It's trying to get these kids ready to go work in poultry processing plants, or it's trying to get the kids ready to go be engineers, or it's trying to get them ready to go to vet school. Those are some of the places we visited over the years. So it has really evolved into what the national trends in education are looking at.
If you look at what the actual math science partnership regulations are from the U.S. Department of Education, you have to have 80 hours of professional learning. You're supposed to have summer institute. And those are your key things that you have to have. And we here, because we go to the MSP regional institutes and the conferences that they have, we hear about other places where they're doing a two-week long summer institute. And then basically the partners just come back and do something again the next summer for 2 weeks. And then the follow-up may be some, may not be there. But we truly believe that professional learning should be embedded throughout the school year, and that if we're going to make a difference, it has to be where, yes, there is that time that's intense in the summer, but it's so important that follow-up throughout the school year, because that's when teachers are with students. That's when they're in there making a difference for students. And so you need to have that continual reminder. You need to see how what we're learning in the summer can actually go with a lesson plan that I'm doing in December. And that's what I think our teachers have come away with from this.
I don't think we would have seen the gains that we've seen in standardized testing. I don't think we would see the excitement that we see with the students that we do now. Kids really look forward to coming to science because they know, for instance, we do one of our projects we do, the students have to design a rocket, and we use it when we do Newton's laws. And we always seem to draw a really big crowd, especially when the rockets don't go off like they should. But we built some rocket launchers, and we go outside in the grassy area, and kids are just plastered to the glass from other classes wanting to know what goes on. And they get so excited, and they start talking about it. In fact, we have open house today, and kids have already asked about some of the projects that they know are coming up. And so it gets them excited, and that's a good feeling as a teacher to know they're really pumped about what's going on.